इज माई वॉइस ऑडिबल टू यू ऑल? ओके, सो गुड मॉर्निंग टू यू. ओके, सो इन द लास्ट क्लास आई थिंक सर हैज केम, ही हैज डिस्कस सम प्रॉब्लम्स ऑन एरर एनालिसिस. ओके, सो टुडे आई विल डू द होमवर्क एंड देन वील डू मोर प्रॉब्लम ऑन दिस परसेंटेज एरर. ओके, सो द फर्स्ट होमवर्क विच आई हैव गिवन टू यू, that was the following observation was taken when using a vernier caliper while measuring the length of the cylinder. Okay, so we have to find the most accurate length of the cylinder. First point, the absolute error. Okay, the absolute error, and then mean absolute error, relative error, and percentage error. Okay, so first thing, we have to find the most accurate length of the cylinder. Okay, okay, so first part of that is, okay, we have to find the most accurate length. So most accurate length, the most accurate length is what? The most accurate length of cylinder is L average. Can we say that or not? L average is the most accurate length. Okay, fine. So how to find the most accurate length? Means L average. What we have to do? What all observation we have done? Just add the observation divided by number of observation. Means 3.29 plus 3.28 plus 3.29. Plus 3.31 plus 3.28 plus 3.27, okay, plus 3.29 and 3.30 divided by number of observation. How many observation we have done? 8. Okay, so what is the most accurate length? That is L average. If you solve this, you'll get the answer as 3.28875 centimeter, or we can say like this, it would be approximately equal to 3.29 centimeter. Okay, fine. So the answer here is 3.29 centimeter. This is the first part answer. Okay, now second part is what? Second is, we have to find the absolute error in each observation. So in each observation, what is the absolute error? So let us suppose the error in first observation, delta L1, that would be equal to 3.29 minus 3.29, that is equal to 0. That is the observation in the first. Okay, second, delta L2, that was equal to what? 3.29 minus 3.28, that will come as 0.01. So similarly, delta L3, that would be equal to how much? 3.29 minus 3.29, which is equal to 0. Then delta L4 will come as 3.29 minus 3.31 minus 3.31. That will come as minus 0.02. Now we know that we always take the modulus. So delta L4 would be equal to how much? Delta L4 will be equal to 0.02. Correct now? Yes, 0.02. Similarly, delta L4, that would be equal to how much? 3.29 minus 3.28. That will come as 0.01. Similarly, delta L5, that would be 3.29 minus 3.28, which is 0.01. Okay, delta L6, that would be 3.29 minus 3.27, that will come as 0.02. Okay, then delta L7, that will be how much? 3.29 minus 3.29, that is 0.00. And the last one is delta L8, that will come as 3.29 minus 3.30, which is minus 0.01, we take the modulus, so answer would be 0.01. Okay, so I hope you got all this answer correct. Second part, okay, fine. Second part, I think you all got the answer correct. Yes, okay. Now what we have to do? Now we have to find the mean of that. Okay, mean absolute error. So what is the mean absolute error? What is the mean absolute error? Two delta L4 why I put, because it was coming as minus 0.02. We have to take the modulus of that. So I have put the modulus there. So I got the answer as 0.02. Modulus means we are taking the magnitude of that thing. Okay, fine. Now next is third part is to find the mean absolute error. Okay, so to find the mean absolute error, what we have to do? We have to add all the errors, delta L1 plus delta L2 plus delta L3 plus delta L4. Okay, so it was 0.00 plus 0.01 plus 0.00 plus 0.00 0.02. Okay, plus 0.01 plus 0.02 plus 0.00 plus 0.01. Okay, 01 it is. Fine. Similarly, we have to simply add all delta L1 plus delta L2 plus delta L3, like this we have to add. And we are getting the mean absolute error as 0.01 centimeter. That is the third part answer. Okay. Now what is fourth part answer? Relative error. Okay. Now what is relative error? That is mean absolute error divided by the average length. Okay. So mean absolute error means delta L. This is delta L. Okay. Mean absolute error is delta L by L average. Okay. So delta L is how much? 0.01 divided by 3.29. So we are getting answer as 0.003 is the relative error. And fifth part is percentage error. Percentage error, that would be how much? Relative error into 100%. Okay, so 0.003 into 100%. We are getting the error as 0.3%. So we have very less error in this question. Okay. So the answer would come as 0.3%. Okay. So I hope most of you have got the answer correct. All the five part which we have done. Okay, very good. Okay, fine. Now next part of this problem is. Okay, next is. Okay. Now next second question was the question number 2. What we have to find? The question is the final and the initial and final temperature of water as recorded by the observer is 40.6 plus minus 0.2 degrees Celsius and 78.3 plus minus 0.3 degrees Celsius. Calculate the rise in temperature with the proper error limits. Okay, so what we have to do, theta 1 is how much? Theta 1 is 40.6 plus minus 0.2 degrees Celsius. And what is theta 2? That is 78.3 plus minus 0.3 degrees Celsius. Okay, that is theta 1 and theta 2. So first we have to find the rise in temperature. Rise in temperature. So what is the rise in temperature? The rise in temperature is theta 2 average minus theta 1 average. Okay, so theta 2 is how much? 78.3 minus 40.6. So we are getting answer as 37.7 degrees Celsius. Okay, 37.7 degrees Celsius. Okay, 17 degree Celsius. This is the rise in temperature. Now what we have to find? We have to find the mean absolute error. Now here, if you look at this, for theta 1, what is the error there? The error is 0.2 degrees Celsius. And what is the error for theta 2? That is 0.3, which means how much? What is the mean of that? That is plus minus delta theta 1 plus delta theta 2. We always have to add the errors. Okay, error is always added. It cannot be subtracted. Okay, so we have this point plus minus 0.3 plus 0.2, that would come as plus minus 0.5 degree Celsius. Okay, so what is the rise in temperature? That the rise in temperature would be equal to the average rise, that is 37.7 plus minus 0.5 degree Celsius. That is the answer. Okay. Yes. Fine. So I think you have got the answer of this. Delta means this is the mean rise in temperature. Okay, that is the mean. So this is the rise in temperature plus minus of theta 1 and theta 2. Okay. Fine. So I think you got this answer also. Next part. Question number 3. The length and the breadth of a rectangle is 5.7 plus minus 0.1 centimeter and 3.4 plus minus 0.2 centimeter. Calculate the area of rectangle with proper error limits. Okay, so length is given as 5.7 plus minus 0.1 centimeter, and the breadth is given as how much? That is 3.4 plus minus 0.2 centimeter. We have to find the area. So first of all, we have to find the average area. The area average would be L into B simply. That is 5.7 into 3.4. When you will solve this, you will get the answer as 19.38 centimeter square. This is the average area. Now how much error is there? Now I told you about the calculation of the errors. Okay. How we have to calculate the errors? Fine. To calculate the error, I think you remember the rule number 3 or 4, 2 something was there. X is equal to A into B. Then how to find the error, relative error? That would be delta X by X would be equal to delta A by A plus delta B by B. That what I told you. So here X is A. So we can write here as delta A by A should be equal to delta L by L plus delta B by B. Correct now? Delta L by L plus delta B by B. Okay, fine. So what is delta A by A? That is the relative error. So delta A by A must be equal to, okay, how much change in length? What is the error in change in length? That is 0.1 divided by the original length is 5.7. Okay, plus in breadth it is 0.2 divided by 3.4. Okay, so we will get delta A by A means relative change in error. Relative error in area would be equal to how much? If you solve this, you will get something around 1.48 divided by 19.38. Now change in area, error in area would be equal to 1.48 by 19.38 into the area. That is 1.48 divided by 19.38 into area is how much? Area we calculated as 19.38. Okay, 19.38. So we are getting something around 1.48. That is A, delta A. So whenever we are writing delta A, we have to write plus minus like this. Okay. We have to write plus minus. Okay, very good. So what is the area now? How can we represent area now? Area would be equal to average area, that is 19.38 plus minus 1.48 centimeter square. This is the area which we calculate with the help of proper error limits. Okay. So 19.38 plus minus 1.48. Okay. Fine. Understood. So this was the homework which I have given to you. Okay. Now we'll do more practice. Okay. Fine. Now we'll do more practice on this percentage error. Okay. I think sir has also done some problems yesterday. I hope you have understood all the problems. Okay, so I'll do one or two problem more. Okay, then we'll go for this significant figures. Understood? Okay, so we have one problem like this. Okay, we have one problem like this. Okay, some relation is given to you, like k is equal to x square q cube divided by z4. Okay, k, some relation k is given, some arbitrary relation I have given to you, k equal to x square q cube, don't take q, take as y. This will be taken as y. Okay, so x square y cube z4. Okay, now x is given as, the value of x is given as 2.1 plus minus 0.1. y is given as 3.2 plus minus 0.2, and z is given to us as 5.6 plus minus 0.05. We have to find the maximum permissible error in k. Okay, fine. Or you have to find the value of k with proper error limits. Okay, the question is find k with proper error limits. Okay, can you solve this problem now? With proper error limits, we have to find the value of the k. Okay. Fine. So see, in this question we have k. K is some physical quantity whose relation is given by x square into y cube by z power 4. X value is 2.1 plus minus 0.1. Y is 3.2 plus minus 0.2. And z is 5.6 plus minus 0.05. Okay. There is some relation k. You have to find the value of k with the proper error limits. Okay. Fine. Okay, so how to solve this problem now? See, first of all, we need to find the value of this k. Okay, so how you find the value of this k? K will be equal to what? K average, we can say. K average will be equal to x square y square by z power 4. What is x average? That is 2.1 into y is 3.2. Z is how much? 5.6. Can you solve this? If you solve, I think your answer would come as around 0.1469. Am I correct or not? Y cube it is. Okay, y cube it is. Okay. So 2.1 whole square, 3.2 y cube, and z 5.6. Okay. So if you solve this, you'll get answer. You're getting the answer around 0.1469. This is the k average value. Okay. Now we have to find the error in k. So how will you find the error in k? Now, I think you know the rule number, last rule which I have explained to you. Have you noticed that last rule? We are taking the appropriate power, na? X square y cube z4 means, see, x average whole square, y average whole cube, and z power 4. Okay, that is how we can find k average. Fine. Now we have to find the, I think this answer is correct or not, 0.1469. Can you verify this answer? The value of k? Correct. Okay. Fine. This is the k average value. Now we have to find the error in k. So I think we have, I explained you the rule number 3, I think. Wait, I'll see you the rule there. I think this was the rule. No, this relative, no, this was not. Wait. I think this was no. Okay, this one I think. This one, huh? Last one. This one, that when x is some relation that a power p, b power q, and s power c power s, then how to find the error in x? The error in x means delta x by x will be equal to p delta a by a plus q delta b by b plus s delta c by c. Is this correct or not? That is the rule number 6. Okay. So that rule number, I think rule number 3, third part. Okay. So if you use this rule, if we do use this rule, what we can get? Where is the question I have typed? Wait. This was the question, huh? See. So we can find the error in K. So error in K, that is delta K. Delta K by K. That would be equal to what? Delta K by K will be equal to 2 delta X by X plus 3 delta Y by Y plus 4 delta Z by Z. Is this correct or not? Put some bracket, write plus minus. Why we are writing plus minus? Because we can take upper limit and lower limit. So we can have to find delta K. So we are writing plus minus K. Did you understand this or not? We have used the rule number 3, part 3. When some relation is given like this, then what is the error in K? The error in K means delta K by K will be equal to 2 times of X delta X by X, 3 times of delta Y by Y, plus 4 times of delta Z by Z. Okay, fine. So, did you understand this step or not? Yes, you have to write in your class work notebook, okay? So, write down in class work notebook, okay? Did you understand this step or not? Simply, we are using the rule which I have explained to you. Okay. Now we have to find the error in K. So how to find the error in K? Okay. How to find the error in K? To find the error in K, that is delta K by K 2 into, what is delta X value? That is 0.1. What is the value of X? 2.1. Plus 3 into, what is the value of the error in Y? That is 0.2. What is the value of Y? 3.2. Plus 4 into 0.05 divided by 5.6. Okay, we need to solve this value. Okay, I have solved this already. So I am getting something around delta K by K will be equal to 0.318. Okay, 0.318. That is delta K by K. Now we can get the value of delta K. So delta K will be equal to 0.318 into K. Now what was the value of the K we have found? 0.1469. So we have to simply multiply here. Okay. That is 0.1469. So we can get the value of delta K. So after solving, I am getting something around plus minus 0.01489. Okay, we can write in two decimal place, that would be equal to plus minus 0.02. So delta K will be equal to plus minus 0.02. Okay, fine. So how can we write the value of K? The value of K will be equal to K average plus minus delta K. Okay, so what is the value of K average? K average is 0.15. Because it is 0.1469, we can write that 0.15 plus minus 0.02. Okay, that is your answer. I hope you understood this. This is the maximum which they can ask. Okay, this is the maximum thing which they can ask. Okay. DK is coming as 0.04. No, it will come as 0.0. I have solved this. It will come as 0.01469 only. See, one thing I tell you, this one, how I put this as 0.15. Okay, I'll tell you in the significant figures. Okay, I have to explain significant figures. Just now you understand that 0.1469 can be approximately written as 0.15. But how I have written this, that I will explain in significant figures. Okay, fine. For now, you understand this. If pi is used in the formula, pi, to, what is the problem in that? Even if pi is used, what is the problem in that? Okay. Explain again. Okay, wait. I'll explain again this sum. Okay. So sum k is some physical quantity whose relation is given by x square y cube by z power 4. X value is 2.1 plus minus 0.1. What do you understand by this point plus minus 0.1? Which means this is the error in x. Okay. 3.2 is the average value of y, which error in y is 0.2. And z is what? 5.6 plus minus 0.05. 0.05 means error in z. Okay. Now we have to find the value of this k with proper error limit. To find the value of the a, first of all, we have to find the k average. Now k average is x square y cube by z power 4. So we have to put the values of x is 2.1 whole square into 3.2 whole cube by 5.6 whole power 4. If you put the value, you'll get the k average value as 0.1469 is the value of the k average. Okay. Now we have to find the error in k. So for finding the error in k, I have given some rules. Okay. Just look at your notes. There I have given the rule number 3, part 3. There if you have this relation, then how to find the error in k? That would be equal to delta k by k is equal to 2 delta x by x plus 3 delta y by y plus 4 delta z by z. You just need to look at that relations. Okay. Fine. Okay. So we have this delta k by k would be equal to, just put the values there, delta x, the value of delta x 0.1 divided by 2.1. Like this, you put the value, you'll get delta k by k value as 0.318. You just multiply with 1.469, you will get something around 0.02. And the value of k would be equal to 0.15 plus minus 0.02. Okay. Okay, sir. Okay. Fine. So one more problem we can do of this. Now if you have studied in class 10th about resistance, okay. So I think you know about Ohm's law, that V equal to IR, where R is the resistance there. Okay, so we can frame one question based on this also. That resistance formula is given by voltage by current. Resistance formula is voltage by current. Now value of the voltage is given by 10 plus minus 0.1 volt. Okay. Second is current I is given as 5 plus minus 0.2 ampere. Okay. Fine. We have to find the value of resistance. Find the value of resistance with proper error limits. Can you get the answer for this? Voltage is given as 10 plus minus 0.1 volt and current is given as 5 plus minus 0.2 ampere. Okay, so we have to find the value of the resistance with proper error limits. Okay, can you get the answer for this? Sir has given this question or what yesterday? Okay, if he has given the question, you can just get me the answer. Okay, just solve it. It would be a practice for you. Okay, so do it now. Okay, do it. Just get the answer quickly. You get the answer. Okay. Two plus minus 0.1 ohm. Okay. Two plus minus 0.06 ohm. I think answer is 2 plus minus 0.1 ohm. Very good. Okay. Answer is 2 plus minus 0.1 ohm. Ohm is the unit of the resistance. Okay. Okay, so I think you all are getting the answer as 2 plus minus 0.1 ohm. Okay, so I think the answer we can simply solve this. First of all, we have to find the R average. So R average would be equal to V by I. V by I means 10 by 5. We are getting as 2 ohm is R average. Now we have to find the error in resistance. So error in resistance means delta R by R must be equal to delta V by V plus delta I by I, correct na? Okay, so error in resistance, that is delta R by 2 is the average value of R. That would be equal to error in voltage, that is 0.1 by 10 plus 0.2 by 5. Okay, so what you are getting here is 0.01 plus, this would be how much? 0.04, I think. Okay, delta R by R. So delta R you will get as how much? 0.05 into 2, that will come as 0.1 ohm. Okay, so what is the value of resistance? That would be equal to R average, that is 2 plus minus 0.1 ohm is the correct answer. Okay, 2 plus minus 0.2. Okay, sorry, I'm again telling you delta, it should be D. Okay, delta here, you mean change. D is also a change. Okay, I think when I was teaching you differentiation, I told you D is also the change and that is also the change. Okay, D is the change when the, you are getting confused in delta and D. Okay, so I think I explained to you delta, when can delta become D? If the X approaches to zero. So both are same only, both are difference only, correct na? Both are difference only. If difference is very small, then we put D instead of delta. Okay, correct na? I hope you understood this. If you use delta also, there is no problem. If you use D also, no problem. Okay, in this question, in error questions, okay. But it's better you use D only. Use D only. I am just telling you delta. You use D only. Okay, fine. I hope you understood. I think sir also explained to you this problem yesterday. So I think you can understand this. More example you want. Wait, I'll give you some neat problem which was asked. Okay, just wait for 1 minute. I'll give you neat problem. See difference, we can see difference, like if difference is 0.1, okay, and the value is 9.8, so difference is very small, so we can write D there. Okay, okay, one more problem you can write here. That was asked in the NEET exam. Okay, just write down this question. Okay, the question is, this was asked in NEET 2013. Okay, in an experiment, four quantities. A, B, C and D are measured, okay, with percentage error as 1%, 2%, 3%, and 4%. Okay, so error in A is 1%, error in B is 2%, error in C is 3%, and error in D is 4%. Okay, respectively. Okay, quantity P is calculated by using formula. Quantity P is calculated as P equal to A cube B square by C D. This is the this is how we are calculating the quantity p, that is a cube b square by c d. Find the percentage error in p. Find the percentage error in p. Okay, this was the problem which was asked in 2013 NEET exam. Okay, can you get the answer for this? 14%. Okay, very good. 14%. Very good. Okay, very good. 14%. So I think you can understand this problem. That is 14%. Yes. Okay, so simple it is. Error in P, that is written as dp by P. This is a relative error. If you multiply with 100%, what we are getting? The percentage error. So if a relative error is multiplied with 100%, we are getting percentage error. So simply we can multiply 100%. Okay, that must be equal to 3 delta A by A plus 2 delta B by B plus delta C by C plus delta D by D. Okay. This sum has already been done. Okay. Okay. If we have written this question, we can do the answer. Okay. So this would be what? 2 into 1 plus 2 into 2 plus 3 plus 4. This would be how much? 7, 9 plus 4. 3A. So 3 plus 4, 7 plus 7, 14% is the answer. Okay. So answer would be 14%. Okay. So this was the neat problem. I think most of the question we have discussed now. Okay. I hope you understood. Oh, see, sometime I'm writing delta, you write D only. No problem. Okay. Fine, or you can write delta also. No problem in that. Okay, you write delta, you write D, no problem. Both are difference only. Okay, both are difference only. Don't worry about that point. Okay, now next is significant figures. Okay, this is also important point. Significant figures. See, delta difference I have explained to you in differentiation. Okay, so you try to just think on this. I have explained you before only. Okay, you was absent, but I cannot explain you now. Otherwise, most of you will tell what is delta and difference. Okay, fine. So. Okay, see, delta is the difference between, say, like two quantities are there, y2 and y1 is there. Okay, y2 is some value, y1 is some value. Okay, so delta y means y2 minus y1. Okay, now if this delta is very, very small, means if difference between them is very, very small, this delta converts to d. So dy equal to y2 minus y1. So when you can convert delta to d, if difference between y2 and y1 is very, very less, like if y2 is 0.4, y1 is 0.1, then difference we can calculate. But if y2 is 0.0001 and y1 is also 0.001, okay, so the difference between is very, very small, then this delta converts to d. Okay, now next is significant figures. Next is significant figures. Okay, now what is significant figures? Basically, the measured value of physical quantity tells us number of the significant figure means it tells us at the value which we have calculated, how much confidence we have in that value. That confidence is known as a significant figure. So if we calculate something, okay, so write down the heading as significant figures. Significant figures. Significant figure from name itself, we can understand if the how much value is significant to us, important to us. Like one example I give you, simple example I am telling you, like when we have to calculate distance between two cities, okay, like from Trichy to Chennai, we have to calculate distance between them. So I can say that distance is 400 kilometers, correct na? Distance 400 kilometer, or we can say like 400.10 kilometer. It means what? 400 kilometer, 100 meters or 10 meters. Okay. Now we don't write in micrometer. Okay. Fine. So we don't write in micrometer. Like we cannot say that we don't write like distance between Trichy and Chennai is how much? 400 kilometer, 100 meter, 2 centimeter, 1 micrometer. Can we? Are we writing like this? We don't consider the centimeter and micrometer. We simply consider this one value, kilometers, and this meters. Okay. We don't go beyond that. We don't go in centimeters. The reason is that it is not significant to us. Okay. Whether the distance between Trichy and Chennai is 100 kilometer, 10 meters, or 2 centimeter, or it is not significant to us. Centimeter is not significant to us. Even meter is not significant to us. Okay. We are only concerned with kilometers in distance between the two, cities like Trichy to Chennai. Okay. Now next thing, like if you are going to a jewelry shop, okay, there if you want to have some object like you are going to jewelry shop, you want to buy some gold. Okay, now if you have ever seen that that measurement device, you will see that that measurement device will have something written like this, 20 gram point, like this 20.325 grams, like this something will be there. Why he is calculating up to 3 decimal place? Can you tell me why is he calculating up to 3 decimal place? Because he that this 3.325 is 0.325 means this value is significant for the gold, because the gold is expensive quantity. So even 1 milligram is having some expense, some value is there. That is why we are calculating up to 3 decimal place in this case. Okay, so for a gold jewelry shop, 20.325 is significant to us. Why it is significant? Because the gold is expensive to us. Even 1 milligram or 1 microgram is expensive to us. Okay, it has some value. But if you see the distance between the two districts like Trichy and Chennai, we don't consider centimeter because it is insignificant to us. Even if it is 10 centimeter or 20 centimeter, it will not affect too much in our question or answer. But in this case, it would affect. Okay, it would affect. That is why we are calculating up to 3 decimal place. Okay, yes, we need more precision in measurement of the gold, like mass of the gold. We need more precision. But in distance between the two cities, we don't need too much precision. We can go for approximate also. Like one more example I can give you. Like a distance between sun and moon. Earth and moon would be somewhat kilometers. We don't calculate in meters there also because it is insignificant to us. Because it is 10,000 kilometers, something would be the answer. We don't write 10,000.12 kilometers. The reason is that it is not significant to us. Okay. So significant figure means the value which we are calculated, how much confidence we have in that value, and how much importance is there for that value. So for the gold, this 0.325 is important to us. But for distance between the two countries, this 0.1 is not important to us. Okay. I hope you understand what is significant figures. We calculate in light years, like a distance between one galaxy to other galaxy is so two light years. One light year is how much kilometer? Okay, understand. So I'll explain again. Okay, see, whenever we are calculating distance between the two countries, cities like Trichy, Chennai, I am writing like 400 kilometers. Somebody is writing 360 kilometers. Okay, but I am going for approximate value, like distance between Chennai and Trichy is 400 kilometers. We don't write 400.10 kilometer. Reason is that even if 100 meter is 100 meter difference is there, it is not significant to us. It will not affect our answer. But when you are going for measurement of the gold, we are writing up to 3.25 grams. The reason is that because even 1 milligram is expensive to us. It has some value. So we have to calculate up to 3 decimal place. We cannot say like, we cannot go for approximate like, okay, you are buying some gold is there, that is 20.52 grams. So the shopkeeper will tell you, okay, we can do for approximate value 21 gram. But when he approximate at 21 gram, then 0.500 gram is lost to him. So he will not do this thing. Okay. That is why he is measuring up to 3 decimal place. Okay. Fine. Where we are using significant, the example I have given to you, like one more example I can give you, like when you are going for buying some vegetable, okay, there you will see that the vegetable would be like 1 kg, 100 grams, like this they will give you, okay, 100 grams, 200 grams, 250 grams, like this he will give you, but he won't calculate up to milligrams, because he know that this vegetable is not so expensive, so even if 100 gram plus minus is there, it will not affect his the value of the quantity. But in gold, this 1 milligram is having some value, so it will affect the expense of the gold. Okay, but 1 kg vegetable will not affect the, even if 100 gram is up and down, it will not affect the expense of the vegetable. Okay, so that is what significant figure means. Okay. I hope you understood the significant figures. Yes or no? Okay. Now, we have certain rules of significant figures. Okay. We have certain rules of significant figures. Okay. How we are converting 20.52 to 20.5. That is what. Significant figure means, you have understood what is significant figures. How much value you have confidence, or how much value is, how much measure value you have confidence. That is significant figures. Okay. Fine. Now you can write down what is significant figures. Significant figure is, it tells us, significant figure tells us the number of digit in which we have confidence. Means in which we have calculated also. Okay. In which we have confidence. That is significant figures. Okay. Okay. That is significant figure. Fine. Now there are some rules of significant figures which we have to remember all the rules. Okay. So we have some rules of significant figures. Okay. First rule is that all non-zero are significant numbers. All non-zero numbers are significant. Like example is there, 1, 2, 3, 7. You can see that 1, 2, 3, 7, all are non-zero number. So how many significant figures we have in this value? That is 4 significant figures. Correct na? Okay. 1, 2, 3, 7 has a thing. How many significant figures? 4. So that is rule number 1. That is all the non-zero are significant. So if non-zero numbers are there, they all are significant. That is the rule number 1. Okay. Second rule. All rule you have to remember. Okay. Now, the zero between the two non-zero number. The zero between the two non-zero are counted as significant figure. Okay, a zero between two non-zero are counted as significant figures. Okay, like the example, we can take this. If some number is like this, 06, 024. Now 0 is between the two non-zero number. If 0 is between the two non-zero number, then how many significant figures we have? 4. In this case also there are 4, which means if 0 is between the two non-zero number, then that 0 is counted as significant figure. Okay. No, we are not telling, I am not telling you separately 1237. The number is 1237, like 1237. So how many significant figures are there? Significant figures are there in 1237? That is 4. Like 6024. How many significant figures are there? That is 4. Okay. I am not counting in separately. Okay. Fine. Next rule is that. Rule number 3. These are the rules of significant figures. Okay. Rule number three is that the zero appears on left of non-zero digit. Zero appears on left of non-zero digit are not significant. Like if I give you some example here, 0.0037. Now the zero is appearing on the left hand side of the digit. This is non-zero number. Left hand side we have zero. Okay, so the left hand side zero is insignificant to us, which means how many significant figures are there in this question? That would be only 2. 3 and 7 is significant. The zero on the left hand side of the non-zero number is insignificant. So answer will be 2. 2, very good. Okay. Answer would be 2. That is rule number 3. Okay. So 0 on the left hand side of a non-zero digit is insignificant. Means in this question, this 0.0037, in that how many significant figures are there? Only 2. Okay. Fine. Okay. One more rule we can write down, then I will show you all the slides. Okay. Next rule is that the number with decimal zero to the right of non-zero are insignificant. Zero to the right of non-zero are insignificant, like 200. Zero is on the right side of the non-zero number. That zero is not a significant, which means how many significant figures are there in this case? That is 1. The zero on the right hand side is insignificant. Okay. Correct na? That is 1. So you can see all the slides. Point 0010037. If the question is 0.001037, the number of significant figure will be 4, because after on the left side of the 1, these are 0, which are insignificant. But 0 is but this 0, that 1037, is between non-zero numbers, so that is significant. Okay, so 0.001037 will have 4 significant figures. Okay. Okay, fine. So you can see all the slides. Today I'm not giving you homework because the homework is on significant figure, which I have not explained to you completely. Okay, so I think we have started from which point? This one, I think. No. Okay, this was the first slide we have discussed. Okay, second slide. Huh, 200.0 will be that is that rule is there. Okay, I will tell you that rule, but 200 is insignificant. Okay, 200 means 200 means one significant figures. Okay. This is homework slide which I have already given to you, 97. Okay, any other doubt you are having? So tomorrow we'll complete significant figures, then we are going for 1 year caliper. Okay, homework I am not giving to you because homework is on this significant figures which I am not explaining to you completely. So tomorrow I'll give you the homework on this. Okay. Yes, I think test is there on Saturday. I think test will be there this week. Okay. So thank you all. 105. Test was in a unit and dimension. Fourth rule is that if zero is on the right hand side of the non-zero number, like 200, so that zero is insignificant to us. Okay, so 200 is insignificant. Zero, double zero of 200 is insignificant. Okay, so how many significant figures are there in 200? That is one only. Okay. No, number without decimal it is. Sorry. Number without decimal it is. Without. Zero to right. Without decimal it is. Not with decimal. Okay. Okay. So I think time is up. So thank you all. Next class, you will see after 5 minutes you will get the class. Okay, whatever class is there. Huh, K sum formula. Okay, K sum formula, some relation is given as P square, PQ, something is there. So first we need to find K average, then we have to find the error in K. Okay. Okay, so thank you all.